ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है। रतिक ये सायु दे रतिक ओके सो ओके सो यू आर फ्रॉम बी आर गुलाब कॉलेज राइट विच चैप्टर यू हैव स्टार्टेड टेल मी बिकॉज इन आई प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव आस्क्ड ध्रुव आई थिंक एंड ही टोल्ड मी मैम नेक्स्ट टाइम टेक वॉट प्लांट वाटर रिलेशंस ओके सो आई डोंट नो अबाउट योर सिलेबस यू टेल मी योर सिलेबस बिकॉज एज इट इज आई थिंक ओनली यू आर देयर So you can tell me your syllabus ki in your college what they have started exactly which chapter otherwise we'll be continuing with the plant water relation only you just tell me let me discuss with you yes Ratik you can say they have started plant water relation only Okay, then we'll be talking about plant-water relation. So you can give a heading for today's date, plant-water relation. Okay. Two things we have to discuss first of all. First of all, I'm going to discuss about two major subtopics, and then we'll be starting about the like how this chapter, like what all subtopics involved in plant-water relations. So before I start with this, let me talk about. So this plant water relations actually it is coming under plant physiology that means how exactly all the activities are going to take place with their functioning so look here now see nutrients plant growth regulators hormones plant growth regulators are called as hormones only then water mineral transportation food transportation everything so when we talk about this like nutrients what we have different substances then what else is given yes growth regulators prepared food substances water and the minerals okay so have to be transported from one place to the another place so we need sometimes specialized tissue system to conduct all these material got it so whether it is water mineral food substances plant hormones everything you are going to consider over here so all parts of the plant body up to the very tip of the growing points because you know that when I say water absorption or the mineral absorption so which part of the plant is coming in your mind it is nothing but roots only got it so roots are going to take all the nutrients from the soil and then it has to be transported to the tip of the plant got it or we can say various parts of the plant Now for this transportation here also you are going to consider two distances the one is short distances and secondly long distances. Okay, so short distances, it is simply by diffusion it takes place. It is simply by diffusion process, it will like that particular organ or a particular tissue is able to take. Got it? But when we talk about long distances, when we talk about long distances, so here comes specialized tissue system. Here comes specialized tissue system, and that we have to see now. Okay. So over small distances, substances move from cell to cell, and you cannot see any specialized tissue. There is no involvement of specialized tissue when for small distances. But for long distances, transport of substances over longer distances through the vascular tissues. So here what we can write it down, for short distances, you don't have any specialized tissue. But for long distances, what you have specialized tissues, and those are nothing but xylem and phloem. So you know that xylem conducts water and minerals. And phloem translocates food which is being synthesized in the leaf, or we can say leaves. Now when we talk about xylem, so xylem kya conduct karega? Water plus minerals, and it is always in unidirectional flow. Uni means what? Only single, one direction. So it is always in the unidirectional flow. When we talk about phloem, which translocates or conducts the food which is being synthesized in the leaf or the leaves, it is multidirectional. It is multidirectional. So along with me, you can write it down because this is very simple to understand. See, transportation hona chahiye, correct, but with the help of two ways. The first way is for short distances and for the long distances. Short distances, there is no involvement of specialized tissue. It is simply through diffusion. And when we talk about long distances, specialized tissues, that means xylem and phloem is involved. So when we talk about xylem, water and mineral transportation, it is always in unidirectional flow, and phloem multidirectional. Okay. So like from root to stem, leaves, flowers and fruits, and that's the reason multidirectional. It is multidirectional in case of minerals and the organic solutes. Got it till here? This is the introductory part. For your understanding, I have revised this. Now, the next thing that you have to study, that is nothing but your properties of water. Because now we are going to link this water molecules with the plant body. So before we start with this, again, this is very important for us to study properties of water. Okay, so please tell me if you are aware of properties of water. I'm not going to discuss this, otherwise I'm going to discuss. You tell me yes or no. If you don't know, I'm going to discuss. You please open your textbook. In your textbook also they have given. So one by one we will just see. If you know, we will skip this point. Tell me. Properties of water, very simple, pure form. Then when it is in a pure form, then pH is maintained, that is, it is neutral. Do you know about pH 0 to 7, then 7 is neutral, 7 to 14. I think you have studied this in chemistry. Now, this is the best solvent for all the solutes. I'm talking about properties of water. Now, we can can consider it as a best solvent for transporting materials or the substances. So it acts as a transporting medium, we can say. Okay, properties. Now this is the again what we can say, the best aqueous solution or the medium for all biochemical reactions. Biochemical reactions means what? Whatever events of chemical reactions taking place in our body, that is actually with the help of enzyme, but it will facilitate very easily with the help of this water. So water solvent. So it is going to help in all biochemical reaction. Now plus the main thing that we have to see, it acts as a raw material for the process of photosynthesis. Plants kya karte hain, it acts as a raw material for the preparation of food. Water acts as a raw material, so it helps in the process of photosynthesis. So this is again very important point you have to remember. Now everything is possible. Why is it so? Why we have many properties of water? It's only because of hydrogen bond present between the molecules. Hydrogen bond present between the water molecules. So that's the reason it is very useful. Got it. Now see, the next property is what? It acts as a good adhesive and the cohesive forces of attraction. Like you can see, good adhesive and cohesive forces of the attraction. Now tell me, what do you mean by cohesive and adhesive forces? What is it? What kind of attraction it is? Tell me. Vinit, waiting room. Who is he? New admission? Yes, Vinit. Ratik, my question is for you. Have you heard about these attractions? No, miss. Okay, I'm going to explain you. Okay, Vinit, yours is new admission. Tell me. Okay, are you there, Vinit? Then, is this your first lecture you are attending? Because I think in 12th standard, Dhruv is there. I think this is your first lecture only. Bio nahi hai? Fir kyun aaya wo? गया क्या वो? ओके, ठीक है, लेट इट बी. सो एडिजिव अट्रैक्शन ड्यू टू द अपोजिट. सो एडिजिव फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन में क्या होता है? हियर अट्रैक्शन ड्यू टू द अपोजिट चार्जेस. दिस इज द अट्रैक्शन. दिस इज द अट्रैक्शन ड्यू टू द अपोजिट charges. And what about cohesive? They are going to stick together. Compactly wo stick ho jayenge. That means attractive. Okay. So next one, then we called it, just now we discussed about, you consider growth hormone, then nutrients you consider, then what else you are going to consider? Yes, prepared food, water. Iska jo transportation hoga, it is with the help of sometimes specialized tissue, sometimes by simple process also. It is going to take place. So simple process is your diffusion process. Slowly, what do you mean by diffusion? First of all, slowly it enters in that particular area and then slowly it spreads out. So diffusion works only for short distances. For example, mujhe sirf yahan se wahan jana hai. So some, like if you are going to consider both the distances, short distances as well as long distances, got it? But for long distances we need specialized tissue, and just now we discussed those are nothing but xylem and the phloem. Clear till here? Now, what a absorbing organ we have to study, and that is your root. What a absorbing organ. So there is one diagram. Diagram is given in your textbook. We will just go through the diagram. What you can do, start drawing the diagram. There is one diagram, rough diagram only I want. Okay, don't waste your time in a drawing diagram only. It will take only half or 1 minute. You just draw rough diagram. Why I'm telling you? Because there they have given maturation area, then you have elongation, cell elongation area, then you have meristematic area where cells are dividing continuously. Got it? So from this diagram you will come to know exactly how it absorbs from the soil. What we are talking about, we are talking about absorbing organ, and in case of plants it is root. So just start drawing it. There is one diagram, it is there in my PDF file also. So very simple diagram, you can draw it. Okay. So you know that root is the main organ of water and mineral absorption. So in this diagram, what you can see is maturation zone. Then root has zone of elongation where cells are elongating. Then you have meristematic region. Meristematic region means what? Ratik, meristematic region is nothing but the region or the area where cells are dividing continuously. And when this is what the area of cell division, then it leads into growth and development of the plant. Growth, we can say. Okay. So this is the typical growth area where cells are dividing continuously. Okay. And this is covered with the root cap. Just do it right now. So here in this, they have mentioned in terrestrial plants absorb water in the form of liquid from the soil. Epiphytic plants like orchids absorb water vapor from air with the help of epiphytic roots, having a special tissue called as velanum. Velamen. So this is there in epiphytic plants. You can write in this way only. In epiphytic plants, we have specialized cells, V-E-L-A-M-E-N. If it is given in your textbook, you can just underline it. Okay, now typical root is divisible into 4 different regions. I told you the zone of absorption, epidermal cells, epiblema cell. In this diagram, you can see. Then you have your unicellular hair extension called as root hair. Here you can see extensions, hair-like structure called as root hair. Now then you have root hair is a cytoplasmic extension. It is just a prolongation actually. Now then You have next thing is nothing but the elongation. The name itself give you the meaning elongation. Can you see this? Huh? यहाँ पे elongate हुआ है part. So cells involved in this will elongate that particular part. That's the reason they have given zone of elongation. Then you have meristematic region. Well, continuous growth is takes place. Continuous cell division is there. And this is covered with the root cap. So we are talking about the absorption organ, and that is nothing but the root. Clear till here? Now we have to see absorption of water by roots. Absorption of water by roots. Now this you have understood. But we have three physical processes. We have three physical processes through which water is going to absorb. Are you getting what I'm explaining? Tell me. तीन ऐसे processes है physical जिससे पानी absorb करते हैं. हाँ, कौन? Roots. Root कैसे पानी absorb करते हैं? We have three physical processes. So just write it down along with me only. Absorption of water by roots. So there are three physical processes. The first one is imbibition. Second, you have diffusion. This is very simple method. Diffusion. And third, we have osmosis. Osmosis. So an osmosis, based on concentration, and migration. We have three types. Please give triple star to this because this is very, very important. Migration based on concentration. Kitna concentration hai uska? Plus how it is going to migrate from lower to higher organism. So that we are going to consider in the beginning of the osmosis only, definition of it. Like how it is from lower to higher or higher to lower. But here, when we talk about migration, based on this, we have again three kind of solutions. Okay, the first one is hypotonic, then we have hypertonic, and the third we have isotonic. We are going to see this in detail. And osmosis, again, there are two types of osmosis. You just complete this flowchart first and then we'll be talking about one by one. What is it? Osmosis, there also we have exosmosis, and here you can write endosmosis. Sorry. Okay, write it down. Okay, once you done, please let me know, ma'am. Yes, I have done, so that I can start. Okay, so first we will discuss about diffusion. What is it? Diffusion is the movement, I told you before also, diffusion will work only for short distances. Diffusion will work only for short distances. मतलब plants में जो transportation होता है, हाँ, तो वो short distance है अगर, यहाँ से यहाँ तक जाना है, then only diffusion will work. Okay, so diffusion is the movement of molecules or we can say ions of a solute or a solvent. So whether it is solid, whether it is liquid or the gas. So it will work for solid, liquid and gas also. So movement of ions of solvent or a solute, whether it is solid, liquid or the gases. Gas from the region of its high concentration to the region of lower concentration. This is called as diffusion. This is called as diffusion. And gases diffuse more rapidly than the what we can say solids, isn't it? Gases, like for example, here they have mentioned about this also. Gases diffuse more rapidly. Got it? Like consider na. Consider your own, what we can say, take one room, living room or bedroom, if it is completely closed, and like if there is something pour, or we can say opening, what will come first? Solid will come first, gas will come first, or the liquid will come first, isn't it? And that's the reason they have mentioned ki gases move, or we can say gases diffuse more rapidly than the solids. Then liquids also and solids also. Now the pressure exerted by tendency of the particles to diffuse from the area of its higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. So the pressure exerted by this is called as diffusion pressure. We called it as diffusion pressure, and it is denoted as dP. dP, that is diffusion pressure. Definition will remain same only, but you need to add here just what we can say, pressure exerted on it. If the pressure is exerted on it, definition will remain same, from high concentration to the area of lower concentration, then this is called as dP, that is diffusion pressure, dP. Now the next one we have to see, what is the importance of diffusion? First is exchange of gases. Look here now, you have studied about stomatal opening, swelling and shrinkage of guard cells. So swelling of guard cells will what is there? There is stomatal pore. What happens when cells swell? Automatically there is opening of stomatal pore, which will allow the entry of gases. Got it? So exchange of gases is very what we can say is simple with the help of this diffusion process. So diffusion, exchange of gases, CO2 and O2 between the plants, interior and the or inner side or the outer side. Got it? This is very simple. Outside air occurs through the diffusion. So you can take this example. Why? Because this is only for short distance. So exchange of gases in case of plant body, it is always through diffusion. So we have that mechanism where cells swell, and which will be then there is opening of stomatal pore, which will allow the entry of gases. O2 and the CO2, exchange of gases takes place with the help of, or we can say through diffusion. Ratik, what you can do is, now while explaining, you write it down somewhere, or if it is given in your textbook, now you underline it. Okay, try to underline. Clear? Now we have to study about imbibition, this one. So here you can write down example कि एक diffusion plant body में कहाँ होता है. So exchange of gases. Then you can write down the definition also. Then you can write down solid, liquid, gases में सबका diffusion हो सकता है. In that this is or gases diffuse more rapidly, in that you can mention here. Complete this table. Then let's talk about imbibition. You just complete it and tell me. Write it down. Exchange of gases, that is O2. See, I have written only the main points. You have to add here, in this flowchart. Exchange of gases means what? O2 and CO2. Then definition, from the area of higher concentration to the area of lower concentration. Diffusion means what? Movements of the ion. Movements of the ions, of solutes or the solvent from the area of higher concentration to the area of lower concentration. That is called as diffusion. सॉलिड में भी, सॉलिड का भी डिफ्यूजन हो सकता है, लिक्विड का भी हो सकता है, गैस का भी हो सकता है, लेकिन सबसे गैस जो है वो डिफ्यूज, गैस सबसे ज्यादा डिफ्यूज हो सकता है कंपेयर टू सॉलिड एंड दी लिक्विड. सो यू राइट इट डाउन. देन वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट डीपी ऑल्सो, द प्रेशर एक्सर्टेड कॉल्ड एज डीपी. यू जस्ट नीड टू, डेफिनेशन विल रिमेन सेम, यू जस्ट नीड टू एड प्रेशर एक्सर्टेड ऑन इट. सो राइट इट डाउन in your own sentences, and then we'll be talking about imbibition. Once you done, let me know that ma'am I have done. Done writing? Show me. Ratik, sorry. Very fast. I'm not able to see your screen. Show me. Lying na, I know. Done? DP definition also, they may ask you for 1 mark. Okay, so you can give single star to that particular term. DP is your diffusion pressure. You can take help of your textbook. If my sentences are not, that means you, if you are not able to remember my sentences, you can take help of your textbook also. Not only you have to underline, but also you have to write in your notebook. Huh? Please make one separate notebook for bio, because many diagrams are coming, are going to come. Hmm? Plus, many flowcharts you have to draw. So you need to make one separate bio textbook. Notebook. Done. Okay. Now the first one we have to see imbibition. Imbibition is the phenomenon of absorption of water only or any other liquid by the solid particles of a substance without forming a solution. So without forming a solution, when there is absorption of water, so we are talking about plant bodies now. So absorption of water from the soil, So imbibition is the phenomenon of absorption of water or any other liquid you consider from by the solid particles of a substance, called as, without forming any solution, called as imbibition. Absorption of water by the solid particles without forming any solution. This is called as imbibition. One familiar example, let me tell you. घर में जो मम्मी स्प्राउट्स करती है ना, रात को पानी में भिगो के उसका लिड एकदम से बंद करके सुबह फिर क्या होता है, व्हाट विल हैपन, दोज लाइक डाइकोटिलेडोनस सीड्स, व्हाट विल हैपन, पूरा पानी उसमें क्या होता है, अब्सॉर्ब हो जाता है. दे विल स्वेल, छोटे मोटे मोटे लाइक व्हाट वी कैन से, ऐसे वो एकदम से स्वेल होके ऐसे बड़े बड़े हो जाते हैं. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो अ काइंड ऑफ इम्बिबेशन प्रोसेस ओनली, जिसमें दे विल अब्सॉर्ब वाटर एंड दिस वाटर अब्सॉर्प्शन इज बाई दोज सीड्स. दैट मीन्स इट इज सॉलिड पार्टिकल्स without forming any solution. So this is called as imbibition. Sprouts, like for example, what we have, matki, chana, what else we can say, many examples are there, very simple and familiar examples you can see. Now at this moment I'm not remembering, but two examples I discussed with you. So that is called as imbibition. Now one more example we can say, solid substances or the absorbent which take part in imbibition is called as imbibents. Imbibents like seeds, dry wood also we can consider, like in rainy season also sometimes, if now it is like we have a glass door and the door which is made up of fiber of plastic, but in earlier what we can say, ancient time, we were having what we can say, doors, wooden doors we were having. Okay, so what happens in rainy season, due to moisture, it becomes very difficult to fit into that particular portion or the area. So that is actually the wood is going to absorb moisture, huh? Because during rainy season also it is moisture is more. So it is difficult to fit that particular what we can say wood or yes into that area. So that is also a kind of imbibition only, huh? Wo fit nahi hota hai acche se. Got it? So that is also imbibition. Understood? Absorption of water or any other liquid by the solid particle without forming any solution called as imbibition. Got it? Now, plant imbibits are hydrophilic. Now, two terms are there, hydrophobic and hydrophilic. Hydrophilic means what? Water lover. And hydrophobic, yes, it is hydrophilic means water lover, yes. And they have highly negative water potential. So, when they come in contact with water, a steep water potential gradient, there is establishment of water gradient, okay, water gradient, and water diffuses rapidly into the absorber till the equilibrium is attained. Jab tak wo equilibrium mein nahi aata hai, tab tak wo pani attain nahi karega. Got it? So water diffuses rapidly when it is going to diffuse rapidly, till equilibrium is attained. Got it? So very simple to understand imbibition. Now let's talk about water potential. What do you mean by water potential? This also they may ask you for 1 mark. Write it down somewhere and write down the definition given in your textbook. Water potential, and it is denoted as, there is one sign,
I think it is correct only.
Okay, what is water potential? Difference between, otherwise you can write it down, difference between the free energy of water molecules in a pure water. Difference between the free energy of water molecules in a pure water and the energy of water in any other system called as water potential. And it is denoted as water in a solution or a plant cell or a tissue is termed or it is termed as water pollution. Jitna pani tissues mein hota hai, cell mein hota hai, possible potential water, presence of that particular water, that is called as water potential. Understood? Water in a solution or in a plant cell or a tissue is termed as water pollution. Presence of water we are talking about. And this is, it is represented by Greek letter called as psi, P-S-Y. P is silent over here. This is denoted as psi. And it is measured in bars and pascals. Water always moves from area of high concentration to the area of lower concentration. So water movement is always in this manner only, from the area of high concentration to the area of lower concentration. Okay. So water potential of a solution can be determined using pure water as a standard of reference. So we are going to take, or we are going to need pure water, isn't it, for reference. I'm so sorry. The pure water at atmosphere pressure has a water potential of zero. So when we consider pure water, so in this case, water potential is always zero. Write it down somewhere. When we talk about pure water, water potential is zero. Water potential is zero. And the presence of solute particles reduces the free energy. And when there is presence of solute particles, what will happen? What will happen if any solute particles you can see in the solvent, that means in a water, it will reduces the free energy. It will reduces the free energy. And therefore, water potential of a solution always less than zero in this condition. If you see any solvents in these, if you see any solutes in this solvent, free energy is reduced, and in this What happens? It is always less than zero. Water potential is always less than zero. So it depends on the conditions actually. When it is zero, when it is less than zero, when it is more than it. So it depends actually on the free energy, whether it is reducing, whether it is increasing. So it is based on pure water also. Jitna water pure hai, utna water potential zero rehta hai. Agar usme kuch addition hai, agar usme kuch solvents add hote hai, not solvents, solutes add hote, then free energy is reduces, and because of this reduction, what will happen? It the water potential is always less than zero. It is always less than zero. Got it? Very simple. Write it down in 2 minutes. Jitna abhi maine bola hai, likho. Ek 3 sentences mein you can cover these points. Huh? Or what I have told you? What is water potential? Denoted by this or represented by this. Then what happens when it is zero? And what happens about free energy when there is addition of dash, dash and dash? Quickly write it down. And then we'll be talking about osmosis. Three diagrams we need to draw. First, you complete water potential and then draw the diagrams. Because diagrams I'm going to draw on blackboard. Otherwise, you will not get it. Osmosis. These brackets you are going to write, you are going to fill it. After writing water potential, write down, upload, draw the diagrams. Hypotonic condition or hypotonic solution, hypertonic and the isotonic, and then I will explain you. And below that, I have drawn 3 brackets. So whatever I'm going to talk with you now, you have to write. Like what happens in hypotonic, whether the cell is going to swell or not. Cell swells or shrinks. What happens in isotonic solution. So everything you have to write. After my explanatory part, not now. Now as of you just write or draw the diagrams. And give heading osmosis, because otherwise in the continuation only, because you must have drawn the flow chart, so in that flow chart only you can continue. First tell me whether you have written about what we can say, water potential or not, because I'm going to ask you questions, huh, and you have to either you have to on your mic and tell me, or you have to write in chat box. Choice is yours. Done. Okay, diagrams also. Okay, so let's talk about osmosis now. Okay, so in case of osmosis, what happens? It is nothing but the movement of water molecules only. Movement of water molecules from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Got it? So this is called as osmosis, only movement of water molecule, no other things involved in it like gases or the solid. In case of imbibition, there is absorption of water by solid particles. In case of diffusion, it can occur like whether it is in a solid form, liquid form or the gaseous. Got it? But in osmosis, it is nothing but the movement of water molecules only from one concentration to the next concentration. Got it? So osmosis is a special type of movement or special type of diffusion of solvent or of water molecules from region of their higher diffusion pressure or free energy to the region of their lower diffusion pressure. Direction and rate of osmosis depend on sum of two forces. Okay. What we can say is direction and the rate. Rate is also important. Direction and the rate. Both the terms or both the things depend on the sum of two forces. What we have? Pressure gradient and the concentration gradient. It is very important. Write down somewhere. Kya bola maine? What do you mean by osmosis? Movement of water molecules. Now this rate, or we can say direction. Direction and the rate. Both the things depend on first thing. Sabse pehle kya hai? Pressure gradient and the concentration gradient. So it depends on concentration gradient. It is not against the concentration gradient. Okay. Now osmosis is of two types. Just now I think it was written here. Exosmosis and the endosmosis. So abhi main jab explain karungi, that time only you have to write it down. Exo and endo. Endo means what? Internal. Exo is external. So how we are going to correlate this? That we will see now. Now, endosmosis and endosmosis is the osmotic entry of water into a cell. That means water intake. There is water intake by the cell body. Movement of water molecule inside the cell is called as exosmosis. So can you see in which diagram it is going to take place exosmosis? Hypo, hyper or isotonic, tell me. Water kahan pe ja raha hai? If water enters in the cell body or the movement of water molecules in the cell body, which type of solution is it? We called it as endosmosis, correct? But which type of solution it is? Hypo or hyper, tell me. Vritik, which one is it? Which one is it? Hypo. Yes. So your first point will be endosmosis over here. Endosmosis. First point, write it down. Where there is intake of water molecules by the cell body. So first point clear, endosmosis. Second is exosmosis. Exo means what? Exactly opposite to endosmosis only. See, in exosmosis, the osmotic withdrawal of water from a cell. There is water removal from the cell is called as exosmosis. And which type of solution it is? In which type of solution it comes? Exosmosis. It is nothing but hypertonic. So your first point here also is hypertonic. Oh, sorry, hypertonic nahi. Exosmosis. Osmosis. Exosmosis. Endosmosis. So written two things. Now clear? In this way only you have to remember. When I say endo, that means you have to remember hypotonic solution. When I say exo, that means hypotonic solution you have to, because both are same only. Here water is going to enter, and here there is removal of water molecule from the cell body. Here intake of water molecule by the cell body. Now solution, a solution having low osmotic concentration as compared to another solution is called as hypotonic. Now let me talk about these three solution. So this is based on concentration. Kitna concentration hai? Whether it is highly concentrated outside the cell or inside the cell. Are you getting what I'm explaining? Concentration, we are talking about types of it based on concentration. So how it is concentrated, outside the cell body or inside the cell body? Plus migration. Migration means what? Whether the water molecule is entering or whether the water molecule is going out. So based on this we have three types: hypotonic, hypertonic, isotonic. This is very easy to understand. No changes at all. You cannot see any changes in the cell body. Concentration remains the same. Concentration remains the same over here. And that's the reason called as isotonic solution. First one clear? Okay. Now when we talk about hypertonic, can you see the shape of the cell? Cells shrink or cell shrinks. Got it? In hypertonic solution, because when we consider outer or surrounding condition in this, what you can see cell is going to here in this, you can see that there is removal of water molecule from the cell body, from the cell, and that's the reason cell shrinks. Second point will come over here. Cell shrinks. Can you see shrinkage of cell? And what about the concentration? Ratik, tell me. What happens with the concentration? Is it more outside or less? Tell me. This you have to write. I'm not going to tell you. What happens in hypotonic solution? Can you see the big cell I have drawn here? Why? Because when there is intake of water molecule, or we can say when water molecule enters in the cell body, cell swells. Cell swells. And what happened with the concentration? Kisme jada hai? Is it more outside or inside? Because this is nothing but the types based on concentration. So we need to consider two concentration, outside concentration and inside concentration. But where it is going to change and how come it is going to change? When there is intake and the removal of water molecule. So this is going to decide in which area concentration is more or less. Okay, now you tell me, what happens in hypertonic solution and what happens in hypotonic solution. Only one point you have to write and tell me. Write it down. See, in this, there is no loss, there is no gain of water molecule, it is same only. Concentration is same only. Here, water passes out of the cell body and water enters the cell body. Hypotonic solution cause endo. And hypertonic solution cause exo. So that also we have written. Okay. Concentration is high or low? Concentration is more. Osmotic concentration is high or low? Tell me. In hypertonic, hypertonic. In hypertonic, osmotic concentration or the osmotic, osmotic concentration only we can say. Yes. Osmotic concentration in case of hypertonic solution is what? Less or more? High, correct. Hyper means more, high. So can you see this concentration, osmotic concentration? Osmotic concentration is high. And here osmotic concentration is low. Inside the cell, it is highly concentrated. But outside the cell, it is low. So a solution having low osmotic concentration compared to another cell is called as hypotonic. It is called as hypotonic. And secondly, we can say that a solution having high osmotic, can you see dotted things I have shown here? A solution. In this solution, if cell is present, this osmotic solution or the concentration is high than the inner part, that means inside the cell, and that is why it is called as hypertonic solution. So here you have to mention how it is osmotic concentration. Complete this flow chart and tell me. Yes ma'am, I have done. So 3 points, 4 points you have to show. Here hypertonic solution cause exo, hypotonic endo. Cell swells, cell shrinks. What happens with osmotic concentration? That also you have to write. And show me. Dan Ratik. Yes. Are you saying something? Yes, what? What? Achha, done. Show me. Try to show me. Because I don't know. I'm not understanding how to see. Here, I think ask to start video. Okay. Not video, actually. Sorry, camera. No. Yes. Show me, Ratik. I'm waiting. I know you have written, but show me. What? Show me na fast. See, only 5 minutes are left. I need to introduce. On your camera. And hold your notebook in front of camera. Yes. Only 4 minutes are left now. That means you have not written, na? See, you are wasting my time and your time. Okay, let it be. Okay, now what we have seen today, we will just revise in last 3 minutes. Plant relation, plant water. Relation we have started. In this we have studied about like when there is transportation of any nutrients, any plant growth regulators, for example, if water transportation, if food translocation, if you consider all these things, isn't it, something is there. So sometimes it is with the specialized tissue, sometimes it is without specialized tissue. So we have many ways, like by diffusion also, for short distances, for long distances. So in this we have studied, got it. Now absorption of water by roots. So we have studied typical structure of it. Then we have three physical processes. Imbibition, I have explained you about imbibition. Diffusion, that is exchange of gases, solid, liquid, gases. In that, gases diffuse more rapidly. Osmosis, water intake, or we can say movement of water molecules. Based on concentration and migration, we have three kinds of solution: hypotonic, hypertonic, and the isotonic. Forget about isotonic, hypo and hyper. Hyper may concentration is more, okay, outside the cell, and inside this cell, there you can see cell in this hypertonic solution, cell shrinks. Plus exo and endo. In this way, it causes exo, it causes endo. The hypotonic solution, cell swells. Concentration more, or less. It is less. So we have studied till this. Next time, I think next topic is plasmolysis. Plasmolysis. Underline the term and write it down in your notebook, plasmolysis. Just try to read it out, what is given in the plasmolysis, what is it exactly, what happens in plasmolysis. So next time we'll be continuing with the plasmolysis. Okay, now done for the day. Bye bye, take care. Yes, what you have to do, write it down now. Plasmolysis you have to read. Write it down somewhere in the notebook. Written? Okay, now I'm going to end the class. Done for the day.